In the previous video, I've explained you a small part of the story. We're going to continue the story from where we have left. Okay, so let's start reading. When the merchant arrived, the king questioned him. What's your name? Such and such, your highness. Were you at home when the dead man burgled your house? Yes, my lord, he broke in and the wall was weak. It fell on him. The accused pleads guilty. Your wall killed this man's brother. You have murdered a man. We have to punish you. So, as soon as the merchant appeared, in the previous video, I have told you one incident of the thief. कि जो thief था, वो उसके वॉल में होल कर रहा था एक रिच मर्चेंट में. जैसे ही वो अंदर स्नीक कर रहा था वैसे ही उसकी वॉल गिर गई, ठीक है, और उसकी ऑन द स्पॉट डेथ हो गई. तो इसकी वजह से जो उसका यंगर ब्रदर था थीफ का, वो फ़ायदा उठाने आया किंग की फुलिशनेस का, और उसने कंप्लेन करी कि रिच मैन, जो रिच मर्चेंट है, उसको एक स्ट्रॉन्ग दीवार बनानी चाहिए थी जिसकी, और उसकी वजह से मेरा जो भाई है जो अपना एंशियंट ट्रेड कर रहा था, दैट इज़ रॉबिंग द हाउस, उसने उसकी डेथ हो गई. सो जो फुलिश किंग थे वो इतने ज़्यादा फुलिश थे, इतने ईडियट थे वो, कि उन्होंने क्या किया, उन्होंने तुरंत मर्चेंट को बुला लिया. ओके, एंड दिस इज़ व्हाट हैपेंड व्हेन द मर्चेंट केम. सो एज सून एज द मर्चेंट अपीयर्ड, द किंग आस्क्ड हिज नेम. देन द किंग आस्क्ड हिम वेदर ही वॉज एट होम वेन द डेड मैन द थीफ वॉज बर्गलिंग हिज हाउस. बर्गलिंग मतलब चोरी करना, रॉबिंग द हाउस. तो उसने, जो किंग था, उसने रिच मर्चेंट से पूछा कि क्या तुम घर पे थे जब ये थीफ है, जब ये तुम्हारी चोरी करने आया था. सो द मर्चेंट रिप्लाइड दैट ही वॉज एट होम ओनली एंड द थीफ मेड अ होल इन द वॉल एंड एंटर्ड द हाउस. तो पूरा इंसिडेंट रिच मर्चेंट ने बताया कि जैसे ही थीफ ने होल किया और उसने मेरा घर के अंदर घुसा, और व्हेन ही वाज ट्राइंग टू गो आउट ऑफ द हाउस वैसे ही फॉल गिर गई बिकॉज इट वाज वीक. देन द किंग टोल्ड द मर्चेंट दैट ही वाज गिल्टी. ही वाज गिल्टी मींस ही वाज द कल्प्रिट. उसको रॉन्ग डोर उसने अनाउंस कर दिया. क्यों? बिकॉज ही फेल्ट दैट द वॉल वाज वीक बिकॉज ऑफ द रिच मर्चेंट एंड द थीफ डाइड and now he would be punished. So what he felt, what was the king's judgment, ki jo king jo thief tha wo ek rich merchant ki wajah se mar gaya. So he accused the rich merchant that he murdered the man, which was so such a foolish act. He didn't noticed that jo wo kar raha tha, jo thief tha, wo us samay rob kar raha tha, that is a crime. उस समय वो लूट रहा था घर, एंड जो ये क्राइम है तो रिच मर्चेंट कैसे इसमें पनिश हो सकता है. बट ही डिडंट नोटिस दैट ही वॉज अ फुलिश पर्सन. लेट्स रीड फर्दर. माय लॉर्ड, दिस वॉल वॉज बिल्ट इन माय फादर्स टाइम. वेट, आई एम सो सॉरी. लॉर्ड, सेड द हेल्पलेस मर्चेंट, I didn't put up the wall. It's really the fault of the man who built the wall. He didn't build it right. You should punish them. So what happened? Next, the merchant pleaded in front of the king. He was requesting that my lord, it was not my fault. So वो क्या request कर रहा था कि वो उसकी fault, उसकी गलती नहीं है. The wall was weak because the person who made the wall did not construct it properly. Now, अब जितने भी, you can see, जितने भी लोग हैं वो king की foolishness का फ़ायदा उठाते हैं. उन्हें पता है कि जो उनका king है, जो उनको rule कर रहा है, वो बहुत foolish है, वो उनकी बातों में influence हो जाएगा. तो what he did, the rich merchant said कि ये मेरी fault नहीं है, जिसने बनाई थी एक ये wall, उसकी fault है. Hence, he should be punished. And further, and what he said next, let's read. Who is that? My lord, This wall was built in my father's time. I know the man. He's an old man now. He lives nearby. So what he said? He further added that the wall was made during his father's time and the person who built is very old and he knew him as he lived nearby. और उनको जानता है ये जिसने वॉल बनाई थी क्योंकि वो बहुत ही पास में रहते हैं मेरे. Okay, let's read further. The next line says, the king sent out messengers to bring in the bricklayer who had built the wall. They brought him tied hand and foot. Okay, so bricklayer मतलब क्या होता है? Bricklayer is a person who lays the bricks and build the wall. जो धीरे धीरे ईंट रख के जो वॉल बनाता है उसको हम bricklayer बोलते हैं. So what happened? What this line means? That the king send his soldier to call that bricklayer, the man, the old man who built this wall, and they tied his hand and feet and brought him in the king's palace. उनके पहले उसको culprit अनाउंस कर दिया इसीलिए उसके हाथ और पैर दोनों बांध दिए. Let's read further. You there, did you build this man's wall in his father's time? Yes, my lord, I did. So what the king asked? The king asked that did he build the wall, and he replied that yes, he did that. The next line says, what kind of a wall is that you built? It has fallen on a poor man and killed him. You have murdered him. We have to punish you by death. So what happened? So the king said that you had built a very weak wall, and that is the reason the wall fell on the poor thief. Now the king was so foolish, he was so idiot that he is calling thief a poor. Poor means बहुत बेचारा. तो इस बेचारे आदमी के हेड पर गिर गई और उसको किल कर दिया तुमने. सो ही एक्यूज द ओल्ड मैन द bricklayer दैट यू हैव मर्डर्ड हिम बिकॉज यू हैव बिल्ट अ वेरी वीक वॉल. And the bricklayer would be punished for it with death. So, अब उसको death sentence देने की penalty, punishment मिलेंगी. Okay. The next paragraph says, before the king would order the execution, the bricklayer pleaded, please listen to me before you give your orders. It's true I built this wall and I was no good, but that was because my mind was not on it. I remember very well a dancing girl who was going up and down the street all day with her anklets jingling, and I couldn't keep my eyes on or my mind on the wall I was building. You must get the dancing girl. I know where she lives. So ab kya kar rahe hain? Everyone knows that the king is very foolish. तो ये बार 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 क्या कर रहे हैं ये लोग बार बार एक दूसरे पे इल्ज़ाम लगा रहे हैं. सो अब उसकी एक्सप्लेनेशन क्या थी bricklayer की? जैसे ही एग्जीक्यूशन स्टार्ट होने वाला था, बिफोर द एग्जीक्यूशन मतलब उसको पनिश करने का कि जो प्रोसीजर वो स्टार्ट होने वाला था, सो द bricklayer pleaded means रिक्वेस्ट करना, टू रिक्वेस्ट. ही सेड that when the king was about to pass the order, the bricklayer requested him to listen to him. He agreed that he did not make the wall properly. So he agreed ki usne wall properly nahi banayi thi, but it was because of a girl. So he blamed a girl who was roaming around in the street and her ankles were making a jingling sound. So he said that he got attracted with the girl. वो उसके जो गर्ल थी जो उस टाइम पर इधर उधर घूमती थी अपने एंकल्स पर और उसके एंकल्स एक जिंगलिंग साउंड देते थे, उससे वो अट्रैक्ट हो गया. एंड ड्यू टू हिज एंकल्स जिंगल साउंड ही वॉज नॉट एबल टू कंसनट्रेट ऑन हिज वर्क. और उस साउंड की वजह से वो अपने वर्क पे कंसनट्रेट नहीं कर पाया, एंड दैट इज़ द रीज़न ही बिल्ट अ वीक वॉल. इट वॉज नॉट हिज मिस्टेक, इट वॉज द फॉल्ट ऑफ द गर्ल. And to that he added कि वो जानता है कि वो dancing girl कहाँ रहती है, and she should be punished instead of him. तो उसको punish करना चाहिए and उस और जो bricklayer है because he is innocent. Okay, the next line says, you are right, the case deepens, we must look into it. It is not easy to judge such complicated case. Let's get the dancer wherever she is. So The case is very simple and clear that he was a thief and first of all he is a criminal. So why we are discussing all these things? But the king was very foolish and he feels that and he was very satisfied with Bricklayer's explanation and he was convinced with him. He tells that the case is very complicated and will not be able to solve it very easily. So he ordered his messengers to get the dancing girl. So now what happened? They ordered the messenger कि अब वो dancing girl को बुलाया जाए क्योंकि वही culprit है. Let's read further. Dancing girl, now as an old woman, came trembling to the court. Did you walk up and down that street many years ago while this poor man was building a wall? Did you see him? Yes, my lord, I remember it very well. So you did walk up and down with your anklets jingling. You were young and you distracted him. So he built a bad wall. It has fallen on a poor thief. It was fallen on a poor burglar and killed him. You have killed an innocent man. You'll be punished. So what happened now? The dancing girl had become very old woman and she was very trembling as she entered the court. So trembling matlab ghabrana, bahut zyada afraid hona aur kaapna, a fear se. So the king asked her that many years ago was she dancing and roaming around in the lane while the bricklayer was constructing the wall. So she asked ki kya tum इधर उधर घूम रही थी डांस करते हुए और अपने एंकल्स जिंगल करते हुए जब ये पुअर मैन ब्रिकलेयर ये जो वॉल बना रहा था. हर मूवमेंट डिस्ट्रैक्टेड हिम एंड द किंग टोल्ड हर दैट योर मूवमेंट्स डिस्ट्रैक्टेड हिम एंड शी कन्फर्म्ड दिस कि येस आई वॉज रोमिंग हेयर एंड देयर इट वॉज करेक्ट. ही टोल्ड हर दैट शी वॉज रोमिंग अराउंड विद हर एंकल्स जिंगलिंग एंड इट डिस्ट्रैक्टेड द ब्रिकलेयर. ड्यू टू दिस रीजन he could not able to work properly and he built a very bad wall which fell on the poor thief. Now again he is calling a thief a poor and an innocent man. Why innocent? Because he was foolish. He wasn't innocent, he was a criminal, but still the king was so foolish that he was calling the thief an innocent man. Okay, so now the king said ki to the dancing girl that you should be punished because it is your mistake that you distracted the bricklayer while he was working, due to which he made a bad wall and which fell on the thief and he was killed. Okay, so let's read further what the dancing girl said. She thought for a minute and said, "My lord, wait, I know now why I was walking up and down the streets. I had given some gold to the goldsmith to make some jewelry for me. He was a lazy scoundrel. He made so many excuses, said he would give it now and he would give it then, and so on all day. He made me walk up and down to his house a dozen times." So who is a goldsmith? A person who makes ornaments, jewelry out of gold. So gold ki jewelry banate hain unko hum goldsmith bolte hain, jinko sunhar bolte hain. And scoundrel means a dishonest person. So ek dishonest person ko hum scoundrel bolte hain. So now the dancing girl gave her explanation. Ab now what happened? The dancing girl transferred the blame onto the another person. This is what is happening from the very beginning, right? From the very beginning of this incident, what is happening? Sab ek dusre pe apna blame dal rahe hain and the king is so foolish that he is not able to decide anything, and he is saying that this case is very complicated. Okay, so what she said to her explanation, that she was roaming around here and there again and again because she had to visit the goldsmith shop, because jo sunhar ki shop ko visit karna tha, because she had given some gold to him to make a jewelry out of it and he was a dishonest person, and he was making excuses for not making her ornaments in time. So what she explained to the king कि उस time पे मुझे मैं इधर उधर इसलिए कर रही थी क्योंकि मुझे मैंने एक गोल्ड स्मिथ को ज्वेलरी बनाने के लिए दी थी गोल्ड की और वो बहुत डिसऑनेस्ट पर्सन था और वो बार बार एक्सक्यूजेस दे रहा था कि वो ऑर्नामेंट्स टाइम पे क्यों नहीं बना पाया. सो ही केप्ट ऑन आस्किंग हर टू कम आफ्टर सम टाइम. ड्यू टू दिस शी हैड टू गो टू हिज हाउस एटलीस्ट अ डजन टाइम्स. मतलब उसको बहुत बार डजन टाइम्स मतलब मैनी टाइम्स उसको अपने घर से गोल्ड स्मिथ की शॉप गोल्ड स्मिथ के घर तक ऐसे करना पड़ा. सो द डांसिंग गर्ल सेड दैट इट वॉज द फॉल्ट ऑफ द गोल्ड स्मिथ. सो वॉट डांसिंग गर्ल सेड कि ये जो फॉल्ट है वो गोल्ड स्मिथ की फॉल्ट है. ओके लेट्स रीड फर्दर. That was when the bricklayer saw me. It was not my fault, my lord. It's a damned goldsmith's fault. So further, this dancing girl says that when the bricklayer saw her and got distracted, it was the fault of the goldsmith because of whom she was roaming in the lane again and again. So the next line says, the poor thing, she's absolutely right, thought the king, weighing the evidences. We have got the real culprit at last. Kept the goldsmith wherever he is finding at once. So now the king says that the poor dancing girl, matlab bechari jo dancing girl thi, she was totally right and he thought a lot and finally he said that now we have got the real culprit. Jo real mein jo iski galti hai, wrongdoer hai jo, वो हमें मिल गया है एंड ही इज़ द गोल्ड स्मिथ. सो ही ऑर्डर्ड टू ब्रिंग द गोल्ड स्मिथ वेरी फास्ट. ओके द नेक्स्ट पैराग्राफ सेज लेट्स रीड इट. द किंग्स बैलेट्स सर्च्ड फॉर द गोल्ड स्मिथ हु वॉज हाइडिंग इन अ कॉर्नर ऑफ हिज शॉप. When he heard the accusation against him, he had his own story to tell. Accusation matlab hota hai to blame someone, and bailiffs hota hai a law officer who makes sure that the decisions of the court are obeyed. To bailiff us person ko bolte hain jo ek law officer hota hai jo make sure karta hai ki jo court mein jo decisions diye gaye hain usko mane wo log. So the bailiff in the king's court went in search for the goldsmith and brought him to the court. The goldsmith was hiding inside the shop as he feared being arrested. So he was hiding. उसको पहले से पता चल गया था कि कुछ ऐसा हो गया है तो वो छुप गया था अपने शॉप में due to fear. So when he was brought in front of the king, he told his side of story. अब जब वो king के कोर्ट में आया तो उसने अपने साइड ऑफ द स्टोरी बताई. सो व्हाट ही सेड लेट्स सी. माय लॉर्ड ही सेड आई एम अ पुअर गोल्ड स्मिथ. इट्स ट्रू आई मेड दिस डांसर्स केम मेनी टाइम्स टू माय डोर्स. आई गेव हर एक्सक्यूजेस बिकॉज आई कुडंट फिनिश माय मेकिंग हर ज्वेलरी बिफोर आई फिनिश द रिच मर्चेंट्स ऑर्डर. दे हैड अ वेडिंग कमिंग एंड दे वुडंट वेट. यू नो हाउ इम्पेशेंट रिच मेन आर. So what he said that the dancing girl was right. He made many excuses and made her visit to her shop many times, but it was not his fault. Again he said ki wo uski fault nahi thi. Again he transferred the blame to the another person, and to that he said that he got an order from the rich merchant and they had a wedding at their place and were in a hurry to get their orders. So जो rich merchant थे उनके घर में शादी थी और उनके जो orders थे वो बहुत hurry में थे, वो बहुत जल्दी में थे, इसलिए उनके order complete करना ज़्यादा important था. To get and that is the reason the dancing girl's work was getting delayed. तो dancing girl का काम जो उनका ornaments बनाने का काम था वो नहीं हो पाया. Okay. So the next paragraph says, who is the rich person who kept you from finishing the poor woman's jewelry, made her walk up and down, which distracted the bricklayer, which made a mess of his wall, which has now fallen on an innocent man and killed him? Can you name him? So the king asked the goldsmith to name that merchant. Ki kaun wo aisa merchant hai jiski wajah se ye jo डांसिंग गर्ल का सारा काम डीले हुआ, जिसकी वजह से उधर इधर उधर इधर उधर अप एंड डाउन उसको वॉक करना पड़ा, जिसकी वजह से ब्रिक लेयर जो था वो डिस्ट्रैक्ट हो गया और जो वॉल वीक बन गई और आज उस इनोसेंट मैन के ऊपर गिर गई। इनोसेंट मैन कौन है? थीफ है यहाँ पर। ओके, सो आई एम जस्ट गोइंग टू एंड दिस वीडियो हेयर। आई एक्सप्लेन यू द फर्दर पार्ट ऑफ द स्टोरी इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो। आई वॉन्ट यू टू गो थ्रू द स्टोरी वट आई हैव एक्सप्लेन्ड एंड learn the difficult words and difficult meaning. Thank you.